What kind of picture do you get in your head when I say she's wealthy? I have a pretty good idea that we're all thinking the same thing. And I also think we would all benefit from a much more expanded and refined definition of wealth. Hi, I'm Farah of Tibetan Healing Movement. And I'd like to discuss the idea of wealth and that we've gotten this narrow idea somehow that wealth is about having money. But I think that's a very unhelpful and it's just not even true definition of wealth. So I would like for us to expand our perception of what wealth is. There's many kinds of richnesses. There's a richness of relationships, of community, of health, of self-worth, of rootedness in place. So there's many kinds of wealth. Now, my teacher, Tulku Lobsang, has developed a program. I mean, the original intention was for it to be used in a corporate environment, and the program is called Leading by Living Your Full Potential. And the framework of the program is around this idea of three wealths. And the three main wealths are of body, mind, and life. And we need all three. We need to focus on all three dimensions of wealth, or else you're not wealthy. And the money part is very small part of the life portion, but it's all so much greater than that. So, in short, wealth of the body means, that you're healthy, but also blissful, that like you feel really good in your body. And the way, I mean, I'm super simplifying all of this, but the way to get there is to be focusing on exercise and food. Right? And then if you don't have wealth of the body, then you have physical pain. So then the mind, wealth of the mind is like a freedom, or I would say a functionality of mind, and also compassion. So it's something with the heart as well. So when you don't have wealth of the mind, you have a lot of mental suffering, like you're not in control of your thoughts and emotions, and you're just along for the ride with this crazy monkey mind. So we want to make the mind more functional, more calm, more peaceful. And practices for this, it's meditation, learning, how to calm and focus the mind, as well as compassion. And this also reduces our mental suffering. And then finally, the third bucket of life, in short, we could say wealth of life means having comfort and beauty. And the practices to get there are practicing give and take. Now, there's so much to unpack there, what that all means. And the program itself actually teaches, so for the body portion, it teaches practices that release tension in the body and open the body and also energize the body. And this is breath practices and practices for the spine. But it's, releasing tension is a big part of that. And then the mind portion, a lot of it's based on Buddhist psychology, and we learn principles there and principles of meditation and how to focus and calm the mind. But we're also learning how to create this map, like figure out what you want and how to get there. Like, who do you need to be, and what are the steps to get to what you want to manifest, I suppose you could say. And then finally, the piece on life, it's very much about relationships and how we relate to others and see ourselves in relation to others. And also identifying and refining our own personal rhythm, sleep and wake cycles, and rhythm with the annual cycles and such. So that's a wealthy program with a wealth of material. And it basically, again, it's focusing on these three buckets of wealth of the body, wealth of the mind, and wealth of life. And we need all three. If you're neglecting one of these, you're not wealthy. And we could even say, while they're all three are very important, mind is probably the most important, because when we have functionality of the mind, we're able to reduce our ignorance, and then that's going to serve us in the other areas, right? If you're ignorant about what's the right exercise or food, then you're going to have more problems with your health. So please expand our definition of wealth, and that's going to really serve us, because if we're just focusing on career, you know, like without a wealth of life, we have problems with our relationship, we have problems with the career and finance and family and all of it. So we do need to focus on wealth of life, but not in neglect of wealth of body and mind. Okay, so let me know your thoughts about wealth, and if you have any contemplations you'd like to share. And if you're interested in this program, let me know, because I can actually offer it. So I'm a certified trainer in this program. Again, it's called Leading by Living Your Full Potential. And it doesn't need to be in a business setting. I've actually been thinking about offering it online to individuals. And it's just getting clarity on these three areas, and getting clarity on what you really want, and writing your life the way you want it to be. And it's very empowering. The program would be like over 6 months. Just, you know, it's very spaced out, because there's reflections and practices that you do. So anyway, I'm starting to think about this. Let me know your thoughts if you'd be interested in learning more about that program, Leading by Living Your Full Potential. Thank you so much for your time and attention, most valuable resource. I hope you found some benefit. And you can learn more about me and my teacher and what I offer at TibetanHealingMovement.com.